What's up, everybody? I got a Yu-Gi-Oh deck for you. It's a deck profile. It's Samurais. It's it's not the new one, so it's not gonna have like all the new stuff in it. But it's a mix between the old school and the new school. Seems to work pretty well. So I'm gonna just jump right into it. Three Cage Mushas. It's a tuner of the deck. He's pretty useless when he's on the field, believe it or not. But that's whatever. He's really just tuner for the deck. Three Kaigekis. If you get him and Cage Musha first turn off the draw, you got an instant Sheehan. One Elder of the Six Samurai. He's pretty much a Cyber Dragon of the deck. If your opponent's got a monster and you don't, you can just drop him. Two Spirits. I'm actually thinking about dropping him to one and actually running two of him, because he's got me out of a bunch of things, like a bunch of almost OTKs. So we'll see. I'm gonna try that. Two Yaichis, really and truly MST with an attack as long as they're face down. But come on, nobody really plays face up spells anymore, so you really only need one of him. Legendary Six Samurai Nishi. Really, I just use him because he's a 17 beater, and if I have two or more on the field, he gains 500, so he'd be just a 22 beater. Two Irus, good for face downs, people who like to set a lot, like to set their monsters a lot, and you have two more than, him and then another Six Samurai on the field or legendary on the field, you can just run them over and pop them. Two Zanjis. He's really good. If you have another one on the field, you'd still take battle damage, but you can bounce off of them and then kill them after the damage step. Anishi, one. He would be so much better if he removed, but he destroys, but he can't attack the turn you use the effect, which is, I guess it's alright, but it would be a lot better if he could removed instead of just destroyed. Two Grandmasters. Easy special summon. Especially if you get like Kaigeki and then Cage Musha. You just summon him and then you have him and Sheehan, which is pretty good. And Great Shogashin. You call him whatever you want, I just call him the Great Shogashin. But really, if you can get him out with Sheehan, you pretty much almost have game. Pretty much. Because once you put a Sheehan out and you have him out, you can negate it with Sheehan, or you can just have him play one magic or trap card, and they can't activate anything else for that turn. And everybody tells me why, or asks me why do I do this, but I play Obelisk the Tormentor, the playable version. I only play him because why not? If you get him out, yay. If not, oh well. He's just in there for if I need like a little extra oomph. I mean, you can't negate him no matter what, but after his summon, you can. But it's whatever. I like him, so. And he's easy to get out with the Samurai because they summon so fast. Alright, and time for the magics. Three Samurai United. This is one of the main draw engines of the deck. Pretty much. And this also works for your opponent too, so if you can, if you find anybody who mirror match, you just drop one of these and be like, go ahead, and then you would get it as well. But pretty much, if for every two, you draw two, so. One Cunning of the Six Samurai. I'm thinking about running two of these because you can really boost your OTKs with this, as long as you do it right. But it's, you trip it off a Six Samurai and get one, so it's. It's basically a one for Six Samurais, as long as they're in the graveyard. One Sheen Smoke Signal. Wish they wouldn't have limited it to one, wish at least two, but it's what they want, not what we want. Gain, you get a Six Samurai level 6 or level 3 or lower to your hand. Sorry. Gateway of the Six. Busted card if you know how to use it. Every time you summon, you get Bushido counters, and you can remove them and do something. Six Strike. This is basically a Heavy Storm or a Lightning Vortex if you do it right. and you have to have three of the six hammers on the field. I only run one of them because it's truly too situational to have it. Heavy Storm, Staple, Book of Moon. It's good to stop anything, pretty much. Monster Reborn, Staple, and Roto Staple in a Warrior deck. Time for the traps. 2, Return of the Six Samurais. Everybody says to run one, but I prefer these over Double Edge because I don't take life points if they get destroyed at the end phase. But I like these better than Double Edge. 2, Reckless Greeds, the other draw engine of the deck. It's better to get those two cards right away than wait for them, because that could be the game, pretty much. But I just run them because it's extra draw power. 1, Double-Edged Sword Technique, as I said, people tell me to run 2, but I don't like taking the life points. But if you got a Kaigeki and a Cage Musha in the graveyard, it's a level 5 instant. Torrential, Staple, Deep Prison, Solemn, Threatening Roar, and Mirror Force. You can never go wrong with a Mirror Force. And time for the Synchros. Well, the side deck, Synchros, whatever you want to call it. Ally Justice Catastor, you're pretty much going to sink for a lot of level 5s with this deck if they ever decide to not bring back a Nishi, which they need to. Catastor, Magical Android, and of course the boss synchro of the deck, Sheehan. Once he touches, you pretty much stop any magic or trap card for that turn. I'm sorry, he's pretty hard to see, but that's Sheehan. Flameville, Urakwaz, whatever his name is, I don't know how to say it. Iron Chain Dragon, Ancient Fairy, Black Rose, Stardust, 2 of them. I had 3, but I figured 3 was overkill. Thought Ruler, Colossal, bring him out when your graveyard's like 30 cards or more, and you pretty much, he's a boss monster afterwards. Red Archfiend, good for your people who like this set a lot. So, number 39, Utopia, and Grenosaurus. With Cage Musha, you can just summon a hand or a spirit, and you can just get him. So, alright, that's my samurai deck. It's really just a test samurai deck. It's not actually a legit one yet. But, alright, I'll have another one soon. Peace.